going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me, cause I'm going big. Going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me, cause I'm going big, going bigger. Postmates, how I deliver. My game too cold, made it shiver. But I'm still a hot boy, cool it down, let it simmer. Hey, see him mad, got him bitter. Can't stop the shine with a dimmer. Only what I give her, and she let her call me baby, but I do not need a sitter. See me dip, yeah, I'm saucin'. People at the bank see me often. Let the money run, it's a faucet. She gave me the that's a faucet. Took over the game, now we all in. I was down in the chips, then went all in. Throwing up the game, ain't no vomit. Make my mama stop working, that's the promise. Going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me, cause I'm going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me, cause I'm
P-P-P-Lo, time to bring the bass back.
Feel like how I feel to be the boss. Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Work it hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. And I gotta win no matter what, like fourth down, Hail Mary, no punch. Like every time I touch down, I gotta stunt. Randy Moss, yeah, my numbers going up. All these trophies, what do I need any more for? Check the stats up, you can check the scoreboard. Check the stats, Jay Critch, I'm the QB. Ran it up and then I went and got a new freeze. How I feel to be the boss, let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How I feel to be the boss, let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon.
Coach, the weather this time of year in the South, perfect. Fall football weather, and we've got the roof wide open here at Mercedes-Benz Stadium in the heart of Georgia. We thought the old place was loud. Somehow this place got even louder a short time ago as the Falcons were introduced to this sellout crowd. We're set to go as the Falcons get ready to match up with Jameis Winston and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. The final playoff push is upon us. It's week 12 of the NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
Ready, blue ready.
And it's getting it home.
Switch.
This is Peyton Barber. He led them in rushing a season ago. A bad start there. A big loss. On their first play from scrimmage, it's second down.
Allen brought him down. A gain of nine brings up second and one.
At the last run got nine. That leaves him with second and a yard.
Come, baby. Come, baby. Woo! Hey, flip. We ain't from the team.
Throwing. Winston. Flushed out right. And this is incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
But just play number three here on the opening drive, and it's an early third and one. The second year man from USC, this is Ronald Jones. The 40, 30, 10. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Ronald Jones, his third touchdown now on the year. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. You talk about explosion plays. Here's one pretty much right out of the gate.
And now they get to ride a wave of emotion, momentum, everything. Just as you described, right out of the gate, big sprint, touchdown. They're excited. But on the other side, they've got to guard against a major letdown because they hit them right in the gut with that one. And now you start to question yourself a little bit when you give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
That's it, baby. We're going to work.
Ryan will bring the Falcons up now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. A carry for Devontae Freeman, who missed most of last season. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
Play clock down to 5, and they're going to burn a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the gun, it's Ryan. He's got Sanu. A nice pickup there, 18 yards. First down, Falcons.
Mohamed Sanu is a guy that is often overlooked because he just quietly goes about his business. But how about last season? Had a career high 838 yards on 66 catches, and he can also play Wildcat quarterback for you as well.
They run Devontae Freeman, and they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. It's a gain of 11, and the Falcons pick up the first. On first and 10, it's Ryan. He's got Freeman here. It's complete. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage. And that is a tough one to cover, the angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction. Then he cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. He's got a man complete. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Calvin Ridley, his 6th touchdown of the season, as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. Bryant's extra point up and good, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it, each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This will be taken in at the 1. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And still a lot of football to be played in this season. We're only in November. A lot can happen between now and January. But if it ended today, they would just be on the outside of the playoff picture looking in. So a lot to fight for.
Yeah, and wasn't it interesting in our meeting with the coaching staff? And they all made sure to let us know. We know where we are right now, but the playoffs don't start tomorrow. We still got some time, and they plan on putting it together, formulating a streak that the whole month of December is still left to play.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. The sack coming from Adrian Claiborne off the edge.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third.
Only one way to describe Ronald Jones' rookie season with Tampa Bay, and that's disappointing. Drafted to be their lead runner, just 23 carries on a team that ranked 29th in the NFL in rushing.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. Just a gain of 2 there, and it's going to bring up a 4th down. 4th down, and the Bucs trot out the former 49er Bradley Pinion to punt it, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon.
The Falcons take over first and 10
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And you know, certainly a lot of football left to be played. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're first place in their division, looking good, looking to be a threat come January.
And let's think about what every team has in their goals, all right? Number one goal is what? Make the playoffs. Number two goal is win your division. Number three goal, and the biggest goal, I think, is to be the highest seed possible that you can be heading into the playoffs so that you can have as many home games as possible to try and get you to the Super Bowl.
And right now, fighting for every win possible to try to at least secure home field for the wild card and or divisional round. From the 25 on second down, Ryan. This one caught by Ridley. Catch number 44 on the year. It's a first down.
Calvin Ridley more than justified his first-round selection in 2018. 64 catches as a rookie and found the end zone 10 times. Did a nice job getting open right there and picking up a first down.
51. Now Ryan on first down. Here's Sanu on the catch. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Looking to throw again on second down. Ryan into double coverage and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 46. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. Good starting field position for him as they come up first and 10. Following the interception, Winston. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. It's caught at the 10. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Chris Godwin, his first touchdown on the year. And the Bucs have taken the lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Ryan on the handoff. It's Freeman. And he'll get about three as he takes this up near the 25. On third down, Ryan. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And got his man complete. Touchdown, Falcons. Calvin Ridley with his second touchdown here in this first half as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Bryant tacks on the extra point, and we've got a tie game here in a back-and-forth first half. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here we go. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. I mean, that's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5.
Wait. Undercut. Tight knife. Let's go.
Winston, a handoff. This is Jones.
And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40.
It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Well, he's broken off some big-time runs here in this first half.
Man, let's just face it. When you go into a game, you think you've got the plays that are going to work, but when you actually get out there and they're starting to happen, your confidence rises, and he's running with terrific ability right now.
Now a pass hauled in downfield. He is out of bounds inside the 35. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Jameis to throw it. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Tack McKinley in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year. Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Here's Winston. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Grab 14 yards, but they're still well shy of a first as that leads to fourth down.
And with the Buccaneers' new coaching staff, you have to figure they're going to want to use O.J. Howard a little bit more this season. 34 catches, 565 yards last year, but that was in only 10 games. 6'6", 251, and can run. Find a way to get him the ball as they just did there.
These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. But I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yeah.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists. Yeah,
and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. Throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete. Austin Hooper, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. A fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. He's going to air one out. But it's intercepted. He was trying to get it to Ridley. Picked off around the 41. And the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
The first down throw for Winston. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Grady Jarrett making his presence felt. He gets the sack. Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
On second down, it's Jones. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
On third down, here's Jones. And Jones is not going to have the first down as they stop him short. Call it no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a fourth and one. Here's Bradley Pinion now as he'll punt it away for the second time. This is fielded at the 7. A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And the Falcons will be taking over 1st and 10. About set to begin their next drive. The Falcons offense at the line. Down 3, under a minute to go. How aggressive are you going to be in this spot?
Not as aggressive as I probably would want to be. Only down 3. I mean, it might as well be even going into the half. That's not a deficit that makes me want to push it and potentially make a mistake in this situation and cost myself even more points.
But boy, getting into field goal range and tying it, that's tempting.
Awfully enticing. You almost talked me into it.
Falls incomplete. Now let's see who this is on. In the pocket, chucked it away. Flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are on the field. Have some awareness. Tackle to tackle. You got to get outside of that tackle box in order to get that done.
Here's Ryan to throw. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. And now the Bucs deciding to take a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. On second down, Freeman trying to run inside, but nothing there.
It was Jason Pierre-Paul who was able to get him down. Ryan now to throw on third down. He's got the completion to Strong. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. Give him 30 yards there. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. And he can't escape the pressure. Ryan goes down. Jason Pierre-Paul, make that now 8 sacks for him on the season. Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. Austin Hooper, the tight end, was the intended target, and it's third down.
Trying to get that one to his tight end, and they've been trying to get the ball to him, but as of yet, unable to successfully complete one. But you know, there's usually a nice comfort zone in throwing to the tight end. Great sight lines, usually right in the middle of the field.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the shotgun, Ryan trying to lay one up deep. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Amazing. Perfectly placed. If that ball goes one extra yard, maybe not even an extra yard, the starting point is the 20.
So there is a reason that a lot of punters are also excellent golfers. They know distance control. You know what else they have? Ready. Same groove motion over and over. Once they have that down, it repeats under pressure.
On the ground, it's Barber to start the drive. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Well, he got what he could there, just trying to move forward and gain a little bit of yardage and create some space. You know the pressure is going to be tough defensively.
Back to the ground, this time with Jones. And he gets this up just shy of the 15. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
They're trying to show you they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. On first and 10, Winston. And that is incomplete. Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail. Second down.
But it's not been the best game for him, but he definitely tried to get by with a little help from his friend there, trying to create a big play.
Couldn't do it, fell incomplete, but you're right, hasn't been a banner game here in the second half, just trying to get going.
Big thing is trying to keep confidence up and continue to fire.
And he'll take this one up over the 20 to the 21-yard line.
Another good run for him. What else is new? That'll put him right at 150 yards for the game. So he's really made his presence felt in this one.
Hey, alert three. Slam. Hatchet.
Again, it's Jones. He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
Partner, I know my grade school teacher's name.
never would believe this, but I can absorb a lesson. I think there's a lesson in this one. He's having a great day running the football, but occasionally they're going to find a way to stop you, aren't they?
Yeah, this time the defense stepped up in what's been so far a tough game for them. Take it at the 37. Powering his way forward. 7 yards on the return after a punt of 39. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
Yeah, not much there that time, and I think we were both wondering once he got out of the box whether he just throw the ball away and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
This one to Ridley, complete. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. 14 yards there on a Falcon first down. Ryan now, five straight completions here in this second half. First and down he goes. A Buccaneer sack. Shaquille Barrett has now recorded 10 sacks on the season. Another try after the first down sack. Ryan.
Now that was just absolute perfect man coverage.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Snags it for the pick.
I tell you, Brandon, it seems like this guy's been all over the field so far. That's his second interception of the game. And so much of playing defense in the NFL, especially when it comes to defending the pass, is all about positioning and technique. And this is fantastic work on both fronts there.
Winston now to throw on first down. And he finds Howard complete. Gets out of a little bit of trouble there with a shifty move. He'll take it up past the six. A gain of six there on first. Back now here on EA Sports. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Second down now. It's Jones. And he'll take this forward only up to about the seven. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a third and three. Gotta figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just gonna be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
And he is going to have the first down as he's up to his own 13-yard line. First time they've looked his way in this game. He comes through picking up the first. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10.
Kill, three, from the team. Kill, kill, kill. Easy, easy, easy. Follow, follow, follow. Just keep bringing it. Let's go.
To throw is Winston. And he's going to be brought down. Back at his own 6-yard line. Grady Jarrett busting through to get him for a loss of six. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. Winston now. Looking downfield for Godwin. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. He's going to fire one deep left sideline, and that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. Critical play in this football game, because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them, because they know that if they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
A good return there, 17 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. Freeman again. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is third and three. Operating from the gun, Ryan. Flush to his right. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. The tally there, minus 8 yards. Leads to fourth down as well. Here's Matt Bosher now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. 46 on his first kick, this one in that neighborhood as well. And this ball's going to be down now right at the 10-yard line. Good spot. So they'll play the field position game here as a very nice punt is going to pin them back.
Yeah, it's almost like watching a game of tennis, or do you prefer ping pong, you know, back and forth like that? That definitely was excellent, wasn't it?
They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones. And not much there at all, as he'll get this only up to about the 11. In on the tackle, Devondre Campbell, Falcons' leading tackler in 2018. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Here's Winston. Looking for Perriman there. He's got him. It's a first down on a gain of 10. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. Now a first down carry by Jones. And he's upended after a gain of 4 up to the 25-yard line.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a second and 6. They'll go again to Jones. And he powers his way up past the 30. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts, as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down.
Switch it.
They'll try and run here with Barber. Fourth down now after a loss of two. I love the look you just gave me because I know what you're thinking. If you're going to run towards the perimeter, you better either stay in bounds or get the first down or both. He didn't either.
Imagine the looks he's getting right now from his team, from his coaches. They go over those scenarios all the time. And as you said, he did neither.
Let's field it at the 8-yard line. 12 yards on the return that time. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this,
and he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Shaquille Barrett in there to drop him as that clock continues to run. Charles, not to point fingers, but how much of this goes on the shoulders of the offensive line? Well, look at the 6 sacks last week. That's the 4th in this game.
Definitely the bulk of the...
And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get forward progress. That'll be a safety. And that disastrous play partner is ultimately going to seal their fate in this one, isn't it?
It certainly is, because they give up the 2 points, but that's not really what did it. It's happened to give up the football. And because they gave up the football, guess what? The other team now can take the ball and close this game out.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And still 2 timeouts defensively, but even if they choose to use those, 3 kneel downs should be enough to get out of here with a victory.
And that's exactly what's being stated into the head coach's headset. Oftentimes they have a guy upstairs who monitors this at the end of the game. A little clock management 101.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. So time has run out on what will be a Tampa Bay victory. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So for the Buccaneers, they move back over 500 now at 6-5. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Jacksonville to take on the Jaguars. Meanwhile, for Atlanta, it's a loss that could hurt them come playoff seeding time as they drop to 8-3. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gordon, saying so long, everybody.
This magic with the gang, we ball out, it can't get tragic. All we got, we gon' let you have it. Stuck in my ways, think I need to change my habits. What would you do if you were me and didn't have it? Look in the mirror, now I'm feeling like a savage. Tell my son I love him, for him I'ma make it happen. Now my dreams reality, not going back to. You say that you proud of me, I turn my back, you laughing. Now I hit the scene, they like lights, camera, action. Living in a dream, now my music, they be blasting. Step out, I'm a star, always in the latest fashion. Had to set the bar, try to catch me lacking. Bank account for my son, he won't have to struggle. You can see it in my eyes, all I do is hustle. They tried to knock me off my feet, I'm ready to rumble. Felt like I ain't ate in weeks, working off the muscle. Oh yeah, oh my, we ride. For my brothers, no lie, all you can die. Never wrong, they right, I ain't changing my side. Yeah, we in it for life. When I've been up, it's magic. With the gang, we ball out, it can't get tragic. All we got, my habits. What would you do if you were me and didn't have the mirror?